coolest part about Ecuador is getting to work with Pastor Manuel. He ministers to 7 Quechuan villages up in the Andes Mountains, and we get to go with him and just interact with the people and see how they worship. And it's really cool to be there with him because they always are really hospitable to us and they take us into their homes, and it's just a really neat experience.
I'm Abby Duvall. I've been to Ecuador 3 times. This will be my 3rd time. And I go back every year because I feel like I've made connections with all the kids there, and I feel like I need to go back because I feel like they want me to come back and teach them about God and like share stories with them and everything. And it's really cool, just this life-changing experience.
I really love Namibia because I have some of my best friends on there, and we go there and we help at the Community Hope School, and it's just really cool to be able to see these kids that really don't have a lot, but they come here voluntarily to get their education and to be something that maybe their parents aren't. And we get to climb mountains at 5 in the morning, see the most beautiful things in the world, and maybe it was just such a great experience to really connect with God, with just the beauty of the country and just being with the kids.
Hi, I'm Carlin Davis, and I went to Namibia this past year, and I love it because the kids that we get to work with are always so fun and very playful, and the people of Africa are just so nice and welcoming, and I can't wait to go back.
I keep on going back to Haiti because of the relationships that I made over the years, and just the kids are just so great, and it's really changed my life. It's such a great trip if you want to be in a medical field or not. It's just wonderful. I'm not who I was.
Hi, I'm Emily Parker, and I go to Haiti. I love this trip because we formed such great relationships with the kids, and they're so sweet, and that's why we keep coming back. But this trip's for everyone. There's playing with the kids and then medical missions, and we just like have so much fun, and it's such a great trip to go on.
I'm Jared Chappell, and I went to the City of Children. I love going to the City of Children because we get to make a difference in the kids' lives. The kids don't have any parents. They're orphans, and we get to like go and show them the love of God, and that really means a ton to them, and they love seeing us come back every year.
I'm Nick Toomey, and I'm going to City of Children again, and the reason why I go back is just because whenever I go, I feel like I'm doing the will of God. I feel like I'm actually making something out of my life, and I feel like I'm changing someone's life when I go.
Hi, my name is Kelsey Fervier. I'm a senior, and last year I went on the New York mission trip for the first time, and I can truly say that it was a life-changing experience. I met like the most fantastic kids at PS 179, where we got to serve as teachers' aides for the week. And I mean, you think that you wouldn't be able to become close to children like within a week, but I felt like they were my own, in a way, like they were my own class, and I made such great relationships.
My name is Steven Smith, and I went on the New York City mission trip. The mission trip is great because you get to really see a different side of New York that you wouldn't see with like the junior trip or a vacation there. And every day you go into the same elementary school, and those kids, they don't have much to look forward to. They just have their day to day. And you go in and you get to just help them and give them something exciting and a new thing. And just, it's a great feeling.
Is not this the kind of fasting I have chosen?
To loose the chains of injustice and untie the cords of the yoke? To set the oppressed free and break every yoke?
Is it not to share your food with the hungry and to provide the poor wanderer with shelter? When you see the naked, to clothe them and not to turn away from your own flesh and blood?
My name is Rebecca Jackson, and I've been going to China. And the reason I go to China is because the Christianity there is so different here. They have to put things at stake to worship God when we don't hear. So I just learn a lot from seeing them and how they put so much at risk to serve the Lord, and how I should serve the Lord with the same passion they do. And the kids there are so loving, and they just accept you no matter what. They have challenges, but it's cool to see how God's working through them and through Shepherd's Field to change China.
I went back to China this year because I connected really well with the kids, and each one of them has a different inspirational story. And not one of them ever complains about different things that they have wrong with them. And it's just really inspiring to see each kid get back up after they've fallen down, and I love it.
Hi, I'm Rachel Ball, and I went on 7 Bridges. I like it because you can just see God everywhere you go, and the people there are just so amazing, and people don't really think it's a real mission trip because it's just in our neighborhood, in our backyard, but it really is, and we really need to focus on the places that need help in the U.S. and Georgia. And it's just really amazing to see everyone just come closer to God and just the presence of God there. So. Thomas, and I've been on Seven Bridges in Atlanta 3 times, and it's just a really amazing trip because you get so close to God, and over the week you gradually make friends with pretty much everybody that goes with you, and it's just so amazing. You help so many people in Atlanta, and you really grow spiritually.
Hi, I'm Zoe Knight, and I went to Jamaica this past spring break. It was a really good trip. It was new for our school, so that was cool. And I made a lot of good friends, and God really just revealed himself through the beauty of the island. And just when we got to work with the infirmary, I'd never really worked with old people before, and it was a really interesting experience, and I really enjoyed it. So.
Hey, I'm Landon. I went to Jamaica last spring break. I had a wonderful time. It was just a great experience. I saw God in so many different ways. One thing I loved doing was going to the infirmary every afternoon. And it's just like an old folks home, and you just get to hear just how their life was and how they got there, and it's just really interesting.
I'm Brianna Mylan, and I went on the Vienna mission trip to Austria, and I thought it was a really life-changing experience because I made so many new friends, and we were able to connect with all the other kids, and I just feel like I go back every year because of that connection, and it makes our connection stronger, and I just love the Vienna mission trip. Grace can be found, so I lay my fist down. Nothing is the same anymore. You changed me from the inside out.
I'm Stuart Butler, and I went to Greece. Greece was a really awesome mission trip because we got to work with all the refugees that go through, that come from the Middle East and North Africa. And we got to play with all the kids from there and see how God is showing himself to the kids, and it was just really awesome.
I'm Charlotte Russo, and I went on the Greece mission trip. And I loved it because not many people know how to help out refugees, and we were able to touch their hearts in ways that I didn't think I would be able to. And they are never in one place. They are always moving around because of their situation. And so it was just fabulous to see God working in them and watching God just change their lives and allowing us to be a part of it. It was an amazing experience.
I'm Catherine Chasen, and I've been on the Cosmo Mission team for the past 2 years. I've really enjoyed going on the Cosmo Mission trip because you get to see Cosmo in all of its poverty and just be a part of helping the community. And being in the community service group, it really shows you a different side of Cosmo. And the people that you go visit and give food to, they would just open up their homes to you and tell you their stories. And even though there's a language barrier, you'd still know that they trust you.
I'm Jenna Overman, and I went to Cosmo last year to the City of Angels. And while I was there, I met one of the angels, Maria. She was new, and she hadn't been there for just a couple months. But the first night we were there, we had a sports night with the kids, and Maria just came right up to me. She hung out with me the entire night, and from then on, Maria didn't leave my side. So, at the end of the trip, they told us that she didn't have any sponsors yet, and I asked my mom if it would be okay if we sponsored Maria, and she said yes. And we got to tell Maria right before we had to say goodbye, and it was so amazing.
If you do away with the yoke of oppression, with the pointing finger and malicious talk,
and if you send yourself in behalf of the hungry and satisfy the needs of the oppressed,
then your light will rise in darkness, and your night will become like the noonday.
The Lord will guide you always. He will satisfy your needs in a sun-scorched land and will strengthen your frame.
You will be like a well-watered garden, like a spring whose waters never fail.
I'm Scott Andrews. I've been on the Hopi trip to Arizona for 2 years now. I went when I was a sophomore, went when I was a junior, and I'm going back this year. I love this trip because it just shows me how much people love God, even though they've gone through such terrible things. And it just shows me that even when things aren't going my way, God still loves me. And that just shows me how great God really is and how He'll always be there for me.
My name is Sydney Smart, and I go to Honduras every year because I feel like it's my responsibility to tell the people that we help about God, because they don't know God. And they wouldn't know God if we didn't come and share with them.
My name is Michael Shalaba. This is my third year going to Honduras, and I love Honduras because mainly the people there, they're just so like loving and caring, and they have like absolutely nothing. Like, they just have like running water barely, and there's like such a happy people, and we're like upset if we don't get like the latest thing for Christmas or something, but they're just like, they really get upset. They work so hard to like fix their community, and we help them, and they're just loving people, and they're happy with whatever they have, which is nothing. And I think we need to develop that as a society.
Hi, I'm Peyton Paul Hill, and I've gone to Kenya the past 3 years. I really love going back every year and continuing the relationships that I've made. It's really helped change my perspective and realize the things that really matter in life. Unforgiven, we are the sons and daughters of our God. We are the saints, we are the children, we've been redeemed, we've been forgiven, we are the sons and daughters of our God.
Hi, my name is Parker Embry, and I've been to Kenya for the last 2 years. And one of the best things about this trip is you get to just build relationships with the people there, and you remember the specific relationship you built. There's this little kid, probably 4 or 5, named King David, and he was just a great little kid, but he was really shy. And by the end of the trip, he was always next to me, always there when I turned around. It was just great to be able to build that relationship, and it's just great that the small relationships you build have just become big relationships in the year you come back, and it's just a great experience.
Your people will rebuild the ancient ruins and will raise up the age-old foundations. You will be called
repairer of broken walls, restorer of streets with dwellings.